president to ignore all the negative pressures that were assembled, and some continue to be assembled against the appointment of Mr. B.D. Lawal as SGF. It will be grossly uncharitable for us to assume that the appointment was smooth and contested and a simple administrative exercise. That is why we are very grateful indeed. For the third reason that we are grateful is because the president has trusted Mr. B.D. Lawal despite his relative inadequate experience in the federal public service at that level. However, he trusted his capacity to learn on the job, his capacity to be rational in his judgment, and his capacity to be honest in the conduct of the assignment entrusted to him. And we are happy to say that Mr. B.D. Lawal has discharged them creditably and wonderfully so far. We are with him in prayers, and we appreciate the President's trust in the Secretary to Government. This occasion is therefore to partly demonstrate that we appreciate your wisdom and the support you continue to give the SGF. Finally, we have all found a credible excuse to come with our royal fathers, our clergymen, our political leaders from most of the political parties, and our supporters from various states to celebrate with the Speaker and the SGF. The truth is that we have actually come to declare our support for your leadership and the success you have achieved in degrading the insurgents in the Northeast, for the ongoing war against corruption, and the strategic measures being adopted to turn around the national economy. We are also gathered not just to celebrate the two most senior public officers here, but to use these two officials as points of contact to all other officials, such as the governors, the senators, members of the House of Reps, the ministers, members of the House of Assembly, the honorable commissioners, chairmen of local government councils, the local government councillors, and all board members of the federal and state levels of Christian faith under this administration. Mr. President, sir, while we take this opportunity to celebrate our public officers, we do not expect them to ignore other Nigerians in the exercise of their duties and dispensation of public opportunities. However, by the same token, we do not expect them to ignore their immediate constituencies in the exercise of those duties. What we require of them is the adoption of strategic balance in catering for all competing groups in the nation. We have absolute confidence that our two senior public officials will do just that. On your part, Mr. President, we do not desire to convey the impression that what you have done is enough and sufficient. We further request your indulgence to accommodate more and qualified members of our community in your government, and to urge you to encourage the governors in the North to emulate your example. That is the way to go in building a just, fair, and equitable Nigeria where we all desire to live in peace and prosperity. Once again, Mr. President, please accept our sincere appreciation for what you have done to us and to Nigeria. Thank you, and God bless.
Sensational Senator Jonathan Zungina. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, permit me to welcome the chairman of the occasion, represented by His Excellency the Governor of Taraba State, to make a special presentation to Mr. President, who is ably going to be represented by the Minister of Interior, Lieutenant General Abdurahman Dambazao, PhD. May I invite His Excellency the chairman of the occasion and the Minister of Interior for the presentations. Camera, please get ready. Whilst we're doing that, Panam Pase Paul, cue in again. The presentation has been done by the chairman of the Nigerian Christian Politicians Forum, Honorable Captain Armuga. One round of applause for the presentation, please. Your Excellency the Chairman, let's welcome our people from the other side again. Permit me to specially salute our mother, amiable lady. I'm told she's a workaholic, a friend of the north, from the south. In the spiritual realm, there's no distance. In the Christian faith, there shouldn't be distance. Daughter of Zion, the Deputy Governor of River State, sitting here now, salute her with me, Dr. Mrs. Ibalebo Harry Banigo. Welcome you again. Thank you for coming for this wonderful solidarity. Equally, let me welcome His Excellency, the Deputy Governor of Kogi State, Right Honorable Simon Chuba. One round of applause for him. Elders in our midst, delegates from all the 19 northern states and the federal capital territory, the organizing committee, let's just enjoy the sounds from Panam Passipor for 5 minutes. On to the colloquium. And after that, we'll start the colloquium. God bless you.
Well, that has been the ever resilient Panam Passipor. They're given a special number. And with that, we'll come to the end of the of our live coverage of the first National Prayer Conference, a forum that has been put together to appreciate President Muhammadu Buhari and also to honor the Speaker of the House of Representatives, Right Honorable Yakubu Dogara, Secretary to the Government of the Federation, Engineer Babacha David Lawal. It's been a program put together by the Northern Nigeria Christian Politicians. At this point, we'd like to thank you for staying with us through the coverage of this program. And we'd right now like to hand you back to our head office for our regular programming.
This has been